The Earth spins each day as it orbits around the Sun once a year. However, from our point of view on the surface of the Earth, it is the Sun that seems to move. Each day it appears to rise, cross the sky from east to west, and set below the horizon. The place where the Sun rises and sets, the path it traces in the sky, and its position relative to the stars changes by a small amount each day in a pattern that repeats over the course of a year. These changes happen because the Earth's axis is tilted relative to the plane in which it orbits the Sun. For half the year, the direction towards the Sun is centered more on the northern part of the Earth, and for the other half of the year, it is the southern part that is oriented more directly towards the Sun. This also affects which parts of the Earth receive more or less direct sunlight and greater or fewer hours of daylight. These variations produce seasonal changes in different parts of the Earth. The changes are less extreme towards the equator and more pronounced towards the northern or southern parts of the Earth. The connection between these changes and the position of the Sun in the sky and on the horizon were likely of importance to many people in the past. If the Sun is observed rising due east on a particular day, the next day it might be observed rising a little more to the north. If tracked each day, it would eventually rise at a maximum point north of east, and then would seem to stop rising any further to the north for a number of days, before beginning to rise a little less to the north each day, until it crosses back through due east and continues on to rise south of east, until reaching a maximum southern position on the horizon. The Sun would also follow a corresponding path in the sky further to the north or south, and setting further to the north or south of west. The daily change in position seems to happen faster towards the midpoint, and appears to slow down at either end of the cycle. The two maximum positions are called solstices, from the Latin for sun and stand still, and they can be distinguished as the northern solstice and the southern solstice. In the northern hemisphere, the northern solstice is more commonly referred to as the summer solstice, and the southern solstice is called the winter solstice. But in the southern hemisphere, it is the southern solstice that occurs in summer, and the northern solstice that occurs in winter. The northern solstice occurs around June 21st, and the southern solstice around December 21st, although the exact date changes because of fractional calendar adjustments. Determining the maximum position of the Sun on the horizon is not the same as determining the exact date of a solstice, because there is so little observable change as the exact time nears. The tilt of the Earth has been decreasing over the last few thousand years, so that today the maximum positions are slightly less extreme than in the past. Towards the equator, the Sun rises at an angle that is more perpendicular to the horizon, and the angle between where it rises at each solstice is not very wide. Near the equator, the Sun also passes directly overhead twice each year as it goes between the northern and southern maximums. When this happens, it is known as a zenith passage. The imaginary lines that define the tropics are the last positions to the north or south of the equator that the Sun can pass directly overhead, and at those latitudes, the zenith passage occurs just once a year at the solstices. The Sun rises at sharper angles relative to the horizon the further north or south a location is positioned on the Earth. In the northern hemisphere, the Sun angles to the south, and in the southern hemisphere it angles to the north. The change in sunrise and sunset positions on the horizon become much more extreme. Beyond the latitudes of the Arctic and Antarctic circles, the extremes reach a point where at one maximum, the Sun never comes over the horizon at all, and at the other it never sets, instead tracing a great circle around the sky, closer to the horizon at midnight, and a bit higher at midday, but always visible. The number of days this occurs increases towards the poles. In modern times, we have labeled the midpoints between solstices as the equinoxes, when the Earth reaches the two points in its orbit where it is oriented exactly sideways to the Sun. The vernal equinox occurs around March 21st and the autumnal equinox around September 21st. They are often referred to as the spring and fall or autumn equinoxes, but since the seasons are opposite in the northern and southern hemispheres, they can also be distinguished universally as the northward equinox and the southward equinox, as the apparent position of the sun is moving in one direction or the other as it passes due east and west, and the amount of daylight becomes more or less equal briefly before beginning to increase or decrease again. Our modern concept of equinox is based on measurements of declination against coordinates. In the past, it is possible that there was some interest in a similar concept of estimating a midpoint in time between solstices, or estimating a rough middle position along an uneven horizon, but this is not as straightforward as it might seem. The equinoxes occur roughly halfway between the solstices in time, but not exactly, because the Earth moves slightly faster and slower at different points along an orbit that is not quite a perfect circle. Even counting the days between solstices to find an approximate midpoint has problems, as determining the exact day of a solstice is difficult, because the position of the sun seems to change very little for several days at each maximum. Other methods for dividing the year further by time intervals, such as cross-quarter days, is another concept connected to these ideas and issues. Any other division of distance along the horizon would not correspond to a division in time, since the sun seems to change position at a varying rate, and would only apply to the irregularities of local topography. How ancient cultures understood and related to the patterns of the sun in the sky and on the horizon are a major focus in archaeoastronomy. In modern times, we often range from thinking very little about these patterns in our everyday lives to focusing only on our modern concepts of science and astronomy. Taking notice of the observable physical realities of the sky as seen from the surface of the Earth can help us to better understand the experience of these phenomena for ourselves.